Yo, what's up? Dante here. Back with another video. Today's video, I'm going to give you my thoughts on the college football playoff rankings and the controversy surrounding Florida State and their snub. So, to give you context, this is week 15. This was last week. This was the week before the title games. So, as you can see, you had Georgia, Michigan, Washington, Florida State, Oregon, Ohio State, Texas, Alabama. And I'm going to Alabama because Alabama jumped all the way to four. But so this was last week before everything happened. This is after Saturday. Michigan is number one because Georgia dropped. Washington moves up. Texas moves up four spots. Alabama moves four spots. Florida State dropped out of the top four. Georgia was kind of out of it. They lost the title game. You can't get in. Oregon lost twice. They're not getting in. They lost to the same team twice. Ohio State didn't even play for a title game, so they're I don't even know why they're in this. If anything, Oregon should be seven, and Ohio State should have dropped to eight just because at least Oregon played in the title game. And honestly, I don't think Ohio State was nowhere as dominant as Oregon was this year. But anyway, these are really inconsequential. My thoughts. The top two are correct. After Georgia lost, Michigan would take the number one spot. Washington would move up to two. And then right here, this is where it gets iffy. I have no problem with Texas jumping in. I believe, if anything, Texas should be ahead of Florida State. I have no problem with that. They dominated. They were actually the only, no, actually Michigan shut out Iowa. Washington lost, they won a close one again to Oregon. But that's been a close, that was a close game the first game. So I have no problem with that. Texas dominated their title game, and Alabama pretty much they dominated. Well, they didn't dominate, but they played a much better game than Georgia. In my opinion, my only issue with this is I can see why Florida State has an issue. First of all, Florida State went undefeated. That's one of the biggest components. If you go undefeated, win all your games, and you're in the Power Five conference, you should be in. But I guess they're going by strength of schedule, and I can see that. But then people forget, if you go by the whole season, Alabama had really weird scares. They had a scare against USF early in the season. And you're saying, wait, well, hey, Dante, that was early in the season. That was when we didn't know what Jalen Milroe was. It doesn't matter. It's USF. They could have had anybody who plays quarterback, they should have beat that team by more than 10 points. I don't know what happened with that. Because you gotta remember, they benched Milroe, put in the other guy. He played better. And I think the week after they put Milroe back in, and he's kind of taken off since then. But if we're looking at that, Florida State, they struggled against Louisville, but Louisville was a very good team this year, so we can't sleep on them. And then they also had that weird game against Northern Alabama, that cupcake game, I think the 2 weeks before, where I do not understand why these Power Five teams are playing cupcakes this late in the season. That should be illegal in your schedule making. If you want to play them games, fine. Play them in the first 3 weeks before you get into conference play. So I guess when you think about it, if you go by strength of schedule, because Alabama played in the tougher conference, in my opinion, though, me personally, I don't think the SEC is as strong as people like to make it out to be. The SEC really is very, it's very top heavy. It's Georgia, Alabama, and then you have like Ole Miss and like Missouri, who are all top 15 teams, as you can see, right? Ole Miss is 11, Missouri is 9. You got LSU. And then that's pretty much it. After LSU, it's like a huge drop. You got Mississippi State, Vandy, Kentucky, Arkansas. Who else is in the SEC? I'm blanking out. South Carolina. There's a lot. People don't understand. There's a lot of bad teams in the SEC. I still don't understand where they get this love that they're the best. If anything, the best conference this year, arguably, you could say was either the Big Ten or the Pac-12. But I don't think people want to hear that. But anyway, my opinion, I don't see anything. I mean, I don't see anything wrong with this. I mean, it is what it is. Like I said, Ohio State didn't play a title game. Oregon lost. Georgia lost. And there's no way you can put in two SEC teams. So the winner had to get in. But I don't know. The only thing I can think of is this is weird that these two teams played head to head. So I guess, I mean, obviously you have to keep Texas ahead of Alabama. But I don't know. Florida State has been the better team all year. Like I said, they had a few scares. And then, we had the thing with Jordan Travis. He's hurt. Hope he gets better. But they still should have been in this. I don't know. You can't use that excuse. Oh, they don't have to start quarterback, so they can't get in. I mean, that's not how that works. They played the game, they won. They should be rewarded. But I mean, look, I can see it from both angles. This top four works, and then I can also see a top four where you can have like Michigan, Washington, Texas, Florida State. I can see that too. But I guess they just had to get an SEC team in there. I mean, someone was gonna miss out anyway. One of these there's five Power Five conferences. There's only four spots. Someone's going to miss it anyway. But I guess they, excuse me. I guess they just had to get Alabama in there so bad. Like that's why I was hoping for Georgia to win, so this foolishness didn't happen. But then you would have the same conversation with Texas and Florida State. Like, do you put in Texas over Florida State? And at that point, I guess you could say, I guess then you'd have an argument that Texas would still jump over Florida State. So I guess if Georgia had won, you could still make the argument Florida State doesn't get in. But I would make the argument Texas has a loss against Oklahoma, who is not, where's Oklahoma? They're 12. But then you have to look at the schedule. Then you have to look at that. Is a one loss Texas team that lost to Oklahoma, is that better than an undefeated season? That is debatable because Oklahoma was not like super dominant this year. You know what I'm saying? They still had two losses. So I don't know, man. I mean, I guess. Ah, this is a lot more difficult than I thought. I thought it was going to be very cut and dry, but apparently not. Yeah. Dang, this is a lot. I didn't think it was going to be. I thought I had this all figured out, but then you break it down. I think what would have had to happen, there had to be more losses. You can't bank on Iowa's atrocious, man. Golly, get out of here, man. How do you score no points? And that bar, so there was a bar in Iowa that was giving out free drinks until they scored any. Not until they scored a touchdown, until they scored any points. So a safety, a field goal, something, some kind of points they scored, then they would stop giving out free drinks. I know they lost so much money that night because they couldn't score any points. I get the little promo. I get the promo. It's a good promo, but you would think they'd get at least a field goal. They didn't even get that. Trash. Such trash. Disgusting. Washington, and then the Washington Oregon thing, that was kind of a toss up. And then you had Texas Oklahoma State, which I didn't see Oklahoma State winning, but the way they got beat, I didn't see that coming. So you were really only banking on Georgia to hold steady, to hold steady. And then some people had Louisville beating Florida State, which I could have seen, but Louisville didn't play all that great, and they haven't played well the last couple of weeks anyway. They lost. They just came off a loss to their in-state rival in Kentucky. But yeah, man, I mean, I can see where Florida State is upset, right? They did what they were supposed to do. They're the only undefeated team. I think they're the first undefeated Power Five team to not make the rank, the college football play. If I'm correct, I'm pretty sure every undefeated Power Five team, or yeah, every undefeated Power Five conference champion has always made this playoff. No one has been undefeated conference title and been snubbed. I don't know. And then this has been years when Alabama's made it and they didn't even make the title game and they still got in. So I don't know what they look at with this with these rankings. It really baffled me. But hey, all you can do is go out there, play your bowl game, and then, you know, get ready for next year. And then hopefully this gets a lot better with the 12-team playoff. My suggest well, I'll save that for I'll save that my I'll save my suggestions for the 12-team playoff in another video. But I just wanted to give my thoughts on these playoff rankings. Yeah, Florida State, man. Hey, I'm sorry. It's just sometimes you just can't beat the powers that be. You know what I mean? You can do it. It's just a hard fact of life. You can do everything right and still not win. It's a sad reality. But they I guess they had to get a marquee team because I guess they couldn't. I guess Michigan, Washington, Texas, and Florida State is not marquee enough, which doesn't make any sense. You got Michigan, one of the winningest programs in college football. You got Washington. Washington, I guess, is the not, but Washington's actually been in it. This is their second time, I think. Texas is Texas. Come on, bro. And Florida State has titles. What are you talking about? Florida State had arguably one of the best coaches in college football history, and Bobby Bowden. So I'm like, you could have lived without Alabama and Georgia this year if you really wanted to. You didn't have to. Alabama's in there, in my opinion, for marquee. Now, unfortunately, now that they're in, they have a, you know, a 25% shot. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking at this now. You know, they're getting hot at the right time. I don't see Michigan beating Alabama. I really don't. I think Washington will beat Texas close. Then you'll have Washington, Alabama. I think Alabama comes out on top. That's just really early predictions, but that may change later on. But yeah, man, I guess I don't know. I don't know, man. This is just a very, very, very strange. Wait, this. Okay. So yeah, like I said, I'm fine with this because I have no stake in this. But if you're a Florida State fan, I get it. I understand. I understand. This hurts. They snubbed you out. You did everything right. You're in the pop. You would think the conference. You would think being in the conference and undefeated will keep you in there. You know what I'm saying? I guess you can say Alabama because they didn't have an in-conference loss. They lost to Texas, but Texas lost to Oklahoma. So yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, all five of these teams are conference title winners. But when you look at the resume, it's undefeated worse than one loss against Oklahoma. It's undefeated worse than one loss against Texas. Now, I get Alabama had the better loss because Texas is a better team. But does that trump undefeated though? Like, it ain't like they had when it comes to conference play, you can only play with who's in your conference, right? And like I said, the SEC is not that strong. I don't know where people have gotten that mixed up. That conference has never been super, super strong. They've had years here and there where, like, you know, like maybe two or three teams come out of the shadows. You know what I'm saying? Like, you may get like Arkansas one year, or like a Kentucky maybe. But like, other than that, it's a lot of bad teams in that conference. And so, I mean, are you saying the SEC has better bad teams than the ACC? I think the ACC has better teams, you know, all around. The only bad team I think is probably like maybe Pitt this year in the ACC. Pitt. Who else am I thinking? Like Virginia Tech, Virginia. But those teams have been kind of on the decline. They've been kind of on the decline for like for years now. So it's not like there's anything new. But like Kentucky's not no perennial power. Vandy's always bad. Arkansas has been in the slump. Mississippi State's been in the slump. You know what I'm saying? So it's I don't know, man. I don't know how to make this. But it is what it is, you know what I mean? Congrats to these four teams. Hopefully we have a good playoff. One other thing I want to mention. There was I seen an article or something on when I was looking up the rankings. And someone said, I think it was Stephen A. Smith, he was like, "Well, you can blame TCU for this." And that is a horrible argument, because they act like TCU got into the playoffs and got blown out in the first round. They beat Michigan. Blowouts happen in title games all the time. We forget USC beat the brakes off Oklahoma back in the day. Who else? Didn't LSU beat the brakes off Clemson? Clemson beat the brakes off Alabama. So Alabama has been blown out in title games before. So it ain't like they're unscathed. They're part of this too. Texas has been smashed in title games. Washington was actually smashed in the playoff game a few years back. So, I mean, come on, dog. Like, TCU is not the issue. I think they're blaming TCU because of how they get it. I was one of the people. I was saying when they lost to Kansas State, I was like, that was it. They were done. They didn't need to be getting in. But hey, they got in. Hey, they proved that they deserve to be there, because Michigan was such a big favorite, and TCU just went out there and played and handled business. It was a close game, but there was a point where they were like up double digits, and then it was just like a lot of back and forth and weird turnovers. But TCU is not the issue for this. Let's get this correct. TCU is not the reason why Florida State is not in. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm done. I'm just rambling. Yeah, hey, it is what it is, man. This is only going to get worse, because next year it'll be 12 teams. Now, hopefully they'll have a better criteria next year. And I'll make a video about that, explaining how they can make this as easy as possible. So, yeah, as always, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And are you a Florida State fan? Do you have an issue with this? Are you an Alabama fan? What do you think? Are you any of these teams? Texas, Washington, Michigan, are you fans of these teams? Let me know. Let me know what you think about this whole situation. And, yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.